Hello, I'm Bill Rao from MS Rowey Antiques in New Orleans, and what we have next to me is an extraordinary sterling silver Epergne created in 1854. Before I tell you about this exceptional Epergne, I want to give you the history of Epernes, because the history of Epernes to me is fascinating. If you ask most people today, do we eat the English style, the French style, or the Russian style, most people would probably say we eat in the French style, but we don't. When we have a formal meal, we eat in the Russian style. What the Russian style is that you would bring one course, take away the course, bring another course, take away the course, until one is finished. The French style of the late 17th and early 18th century, which was the popular way that most people on the continent ate, is they brought all the food at one time. And the problem with that was all but for the largest tables, there was not room on the table for everything. So the French created something called an Epergne, which was a bastardization of the French term to save, because it was saving space, to lift some food off the table to make more room for more of it. In the Russian style as we eat, that is far not as necessary because we're eating a course at a time. So, but there's no actually known very early 18th century French Epernes, but the English took the term Epergne and created, they perfected it. And there's nothing like the great English Epernes. And to me, there's nothing at all like the great English Epernes that were used, made to commemorate the great events that had happened in their day. Great Epergne was made to commemorate the building of the Glasgow Bridge. Here's the Glasgow Bridge right here. And it was considered an engineering marvel because it spanned the giant river in Glasgow, and most people did not think it could ever be built. And it was built by a gentleman by the name of William York. So this Epergne was given to William York upon the completion of this wonderful engineering and beautiful marvel of Glasgow Bridge, which still stands today. And it was all representative. The feudal history of Glasgow is represented here. Here is Neptune, which of course was king of the sea. Referring to the course of water on the backside, which we'll show you in a second, is Rule Britannica. Britannica representing the English Isles. And it's just, whereas most Epernes are about this large, this one is three or four times the size, and it was this extraordinary gift of something that would have been very valuable, but showing how appreciated this person was. And obviously, it's the only one like it in the world, and it's something that's extraordinarily special, and it just really doesn't get any finer than this.